गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर जॉइंट स्टॉक कंपनी। एज द नीड अराइजेस, वट एवर द नीड ऑफ द आवर, द पीपल हैव टू गो अकॉर्डिंगली। सोल प्रोवाइडरशिप एंड पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म ऑफ बिजनेस cannot take much risk. They do not have huge amount of capital. So the need of joint stock company or a company form of business arose. And with the need of the hour, this was taking place. Now, what is the meaning of joint stock company? So James Stephenson says that a company is an association of many persons who contribute money or money's worth to a common stock and employ it in some trade or in business, and who share profit and loss arising therefrom. Means a company form of business is a form of business where many people are contributing their capital. They are investing money or money's worth for a common purpose in a common stock, and that particular stock is used in one or the other business, means in a business or in trade, and that comes, whatever the profit or loss comes, that is shared by all. Clear? Now, and what the Companies Act says, the Companies Act 1956 says that a company is defined as a company limited by shares having a permanent paid up or nominal capital of fixed amount divided into shares. The company's capital is divided into very small parts, and these small parts are called shares. Suppose a company's capital is 1 lakh rupees, it might be divided into 10,000 shares of rupees, 10 each. So that is called shares. What does Professor Hene says? He says that joint stock company is a voluntary association of individuals for profit. It is a voluntary association, means people voluntarily are joining together, members are joining together, investing their capital for the profit. Clear? And having a capital which is divided into transferable shares. These shares are transferable. These can be transferred to other persons also. And the ownership, which is the condition of membership. Clear? So for taking the membership or ownership, this is the condition that one must have the shares of the company. So here meaning and definition ends. Next, now what are the objectives of joint stock company? Why this joint stock company arose, or why the joint stock company was established, that is called objectives of joint stock company. Now what are this? First is for rapid industrialization. For rapid industrialization of the country is essential for achieving the objectives of 5-year plans. Whatever 5-year plans are made by the company by the ministers, that is achieved only by this industrialization. Or this industrialization is only possible with the help of increasing the joint stock company. Next is large scale production. Economic progress of any country is not possible without higher productivity and better quality products. When better quality products are produced in large quantity, then only economic progress is possible of any country. So for large scale production, there was a need of joint stock company. In the partnership and sole proprietorship, it was not possible at all that to have a large scale production. It was only possible by joint stock company. Next is better utilization of resources. Better utilization of resources. Corporate organization can make better use of country's resources with the application of modern techniques and modern methods of production and distribution. By the joint stock company, modern techniques are used, advanced technology is used for better productivity, even good network of distribution is used, so that all the country's resources are used at the fullest. The better utilization is optimum use of these resources is only possible with the help of joint stock company. Next is mobilization of idle resources. A public limited company can mobilize scattered and small savings of public. These financial resources are invested in industry. In this way, corporate organization seeks to increase the rate of capital formation in the country. Next is self-reliance. In order to become self-reliant, a country has number of industries, means it should have good industrialization, more and more industries. That is, production of crude oil in the country will help to reduce the import bill. Not only import substitution, even export can also be increased with the help of joint stock company, because these joint stock company produce in a very large quantity, in heavy quantity, and this because it has higher productivity techniques, good fertilizers, good pesticides, everything is produced, good techniques are used, modern techniques are used, so that they have higher productivity, and with this higher productivity, after meeting the own consumption of the country, the remaining surplus is sold in the other countries, to the other countries, and it also increases the export and it also increases the foreign exchange. So country becomes self-reliance, and import substitution and export oriented industries in a big way can undertake the it is by the joint stock company. Next is growth of social sector and rural economy. Another objective of joint stock company is to help the growth of social sector like banking, insurance, transport, education, public health. These sectors are also improved with the help of joint stock company. Corporate organization also seeks to develop the rural economy. Agro-based industries such as sugar, tea, cotton, jute, etc. help to boost agriculture and revive rural economy. Next is employment generation. In joint stock company, lakhs of people are working together, and these are employed only in the joint stock company. In partnership and in sole proprietorship, very few are getting employment, but in joint stock company, because they go for higher production, maximum production, large scale production, they need maximum employees. So employment also takes place. And last is improvement in the standard of living. This joint stock company provides better quality product at the cheaper rate. So standard of living of people also increases. So corporate organization aims at raising living standard of people through supply of better quality products and services at lower prices. It can also undertake research and development to improve the quality and reduce prices. As a result, the luxury of yesterdays like refrigerator, television, car, etc. have become necessity of today. So here this topic ends. Today we discussed about the joint stock company, the meaning of joint stock company, definition of joint stock company, and the objectives of joint stock company, which is very important topics. So here this topic ends. Next lecture we will be discussing about merits and demerits of joint stock company. Till then, thank you, goodbye.